streams of data, in the form of bits reaches network gateway from various sources. The gateway forwards it to the eNode B, but how does the eNode B convert them into radio signals and transmit them to the user over the air interface? How does the user equipment communicate back with the eNode B? Hello friends! Welcome back to the world of 4G. Today we will discuss uplink and downlink data transmission in the network.
As discussed earlier, data is transmitted in OFDMA over parallel subcarriers of 15 kHz. The subcarriers are further divided on the time axis as blocks of one symbol duration, or 66.7 microseconds. This basic unit is known as resource element. Each resource element carries one symbol. Now, in order to transmit data over these resource elements, first data is modulated with specific modulation scheme. This scheme depends on the physical channels mapped on the resource grid. Suppose we have 8 bits of data to be transmitted using UPSK modulation. The data will be divided into 4 parallel streams of 2 bits. Phase and amplitude assignment is done according to the QPSK constellation. Finally, data is placed over the resource elements by adjusting the phase and amplitude of subcarrier to those derived for the data stream. Mathematically, it means multiplying the complex modulation symbol to the corresponding subcarrier frequency. Thus, in a 20 MHz channel, all the 1200 resource elements carrying 1200 symbols over 1200 subcarriers are modulated with appropriate modulation scheme. Now, since the data is modulated over 1200 subcarriers, a transmitter will require 1200 oscillators for its generation, and another 1200 will be required by the receiver for proper demodulation. The hardware complexity and sheer amount of power consumption would have left OFDM to theoretical idea and far from implementation. OFDM was made reality with the advent of digital signal processing techniques. So, instead of using 1200 oscillators, IFFT solves this problem by converting the parallel frequency domain signals into samples of a composite time domain signal, which are much easier to generate at transmitter side. All we need to do is to send these time domain samples at radio frequencies. As the data is being sampled by IFFT, samples must be taken above the Nyquist rate for faithful reproduction at the receiver. For an LTE spectrum of 20 MHz, the highest frequency component is 9 MHz, which means the sampling rate should be greater than 18 megasamples per second. In other words, 1200 samples per OFDM symbol of 66.7 microseconds. Since UMTS had a sampling rate of 3.84 megasamples per second, to achieve backwards compatibility, sampling rate in LTE is taken as multiple of 3.84 megasamples per second. Thus, for 20 MHz spectrum, which has a sampling rate of 30.72 megasamples per second, there are 2048 samples per symbol in OFDMA. The FFT size of the IFFT processor thus depends on the LTE bandwidth as shown.
Now, previously we have shown, in wireless channel due to multipath propagation, we face delay spread and inter-symbol interference. We have also discussed how its effect can be reduced by increasing the symbol duration. Also, how guard period were used to eliminate it. But abrupt changes in time domain during transition period from symbol to guard period causes intercarrier interference in frequency domain and disturbs the orthogonality between subcarriers. So in OFDMA, we employ a more complex kind of guard period, called cyclic prefix, in which end part of a symbol is transmitted in the preceding guard period. It also ensures orthogonality between the subcarriers by keeping the OFDM symbol periodic over the extended symbol duration and therefore, avoiding intercarrier and interchannel interference simultaneously. Since OFDMA uses composite IFFT samples, cyclic prefix is added by taking some samples from the end of a symbol period and placing them at the beginning.
Now this time sampled signal is converted into analog wave by a digital to analog converter. Further, composite waveform is modulated at the desired radio frequency for transmission. For an example, an operator having license for 2320 MHz to 2340 MHz. The 18 MHz band will be mapped from 2321 MHz to 2339 MHz using analog modulation. And finally, the anode B transmits signal over air. Anode B informs the user about the allocated subcarriers and the corresponding modulation scheme. So, when the RF signal reaches at the user's terminal, all these processes are reversed and finally user is able to receive the data intended for it.
Although there are many positives in OFDMA, but IFFT summation of multiple parallel subcarrier results in high peak to average power ratio. High PAPR results in high power consumption for signal generation, but handheld devices have limited power capacity. This makes OFDMA unfavorable for uplink transmission. In order to overcome this, LTE uses SCFDMA in uplink direction. In OFDMA, we have one-to-one mapping between symbol and subcarrier, but SCFDMA allows a symbol to be transmitted in parts over multiple subcarriers. For example, in OFDMA, one symbol occupies one subcarrier of 15 kHz. But in SCFDMA, same symbol is distributed among multiple subcarriers of 15 kHz. In short, SCFDMA behaves like a single carrier system with short symbol duration compared to OFDMA. To achieve this, SCFDMA introduces an endpoint FFT block right after the serial to parallel converter in the OFDMA structure. The FFT block converts parallel sequence of symbols in time domain to different frequency points. Now, peak to average power ratio is proportional to the square of number of carriers involved. SCFDMA reduces PAPR by reducing the number of carriers. Obviously, there are problems in single carrier transmission as we discussed earlier, but the side effects are reduced by ensuring that the total bandwidth over which a symbol is transmitted is still not too high. Apart from this, remaining block in the uplink direction is same as used in downlink direction.
In our next video, we will be talking about physical, transport and logical channels used in long-term evolution. So friends, don't forget to subscribe to our channel, like our videos and comments, reviews or suggestions.